Hello everyone. Welcome to Holy Marriage Blessing, the Ministry of the Unification Families of Kingston. And I'm your host, Tyler Hendricks, here with our co-host, Pastor Ruth Muanda. And we welcome you, and we want to continue our series on internal preparation for Christmas. And this week, we're going to look at Jesus as the only begotten Son of God and Jesus as a beautiful gift from God. The Bible says that God gave to the world His only begotten Son that we might have eternal life. So Christmas is a time of celebrating God's gift of life to the world, God's gift of His Son. And we replicate that. We do the same thing in our lives at Christmas time by giving gifts to each other. And that's why we're happy. Ultimately, we love to receive gifts. And deeper than that, we love to give gifts and then to see others happy when they open our gifts. So this is why everyone is happy. It's a happy time of year because everyone is giving to us, and on a deeper level, we are giving to everyone. And we can see how happy it makes everyone feel. So the happiness multiplies and the joy multiplies by giving gifts. So when we look at this more deeply, we can see that it starts with God. God is the one who gave everything to this world. And when our first ancestors rejected what God gave, God still gave His only begotten Son. God simply keeps giving. And we learn this lesson at least one day a year when we make a great effort to give to others, to give without worrying about receiving. Now that's something that it takes a great deal of maturity to accomplish. We usually want to receive first and then we give back. But Christmas is a time when we just give. We just give. And if we're really mature, we just don't even worry about receiving back. Why? Because just the presence of that person to whom we are giving, that is a gift enough. For example, with parents who have children, they are gifts from God. So we give gifts to our children. The children already gave back. The children are God's gift to us. So we're just happy as parents. Therefore, Christmas is truly the best time of year to understand the heart of God. You're listening to Holy Marriage Blessing, the Ministry of the Unification Families of Kingston, founded by the True Parents, True Father Sun Myung Moon, True Mother Hak Jahan Moon, called by Jesus and led by the Holy Spirit, Bible-based ministry. And we have to proclaim True Parents. We want to proclaim True Parents. They came from Korea. They came from, as Isaiah 46, I will call a bird of prey from the land of the east who will come and do the will that I had from the beginning. The kings from the east came to find Jesus. True Parents are the Savior from the land of the East. They received guidance from Jesus and the Holy Spirit their whole lives. They were born on the same foundation as Jesus. And so we think about Jesus' birth in a manger, in a lonely, cold place. And we have to reflect on that. And that's what we're going to do today as part of our internal preparation for Christmas. So we know from the Bible that Jesus is the only begotten Son. John calls Jesus the only begotten Son in the King James Version of the Bible. And that only begotten Son phrase came into the Nicene Creed. So it became a very foundational belief. We believe that an only begotten Son is a Son who is born free from sin, free from Satan's claim. That Mary and Jesus' Father made conditions that their love was absolutely pure, absolutely untainted, sinless, selfless, and thus could give rise to the only begotten Son. And here's what True Father Sun Myung-moon teaches, is that we can leap beyond that. It's not just the only begotten Son. A woman can also be only begotten. God wants to have an only begotten daughter, not just an only begotten son. You know, when you're parents and you have a son, what do you want next? You want a daughter. You have a daughter, what do you want next? You want a son. The same thing with God. And so God created Adam and Eve, a son and a daughter, male and female. In fact, in his image, he created them, male and female. So Father Moon said, if there is an only begotten son, there is also an only begotten daughter. What is the purpose? What is the ideal of an only begotten son and only begotten daughter? We'll talk about that a bit later. So I'm going to ask Pastor Ruth to share with us biblical words and words from True Father Sun Myung-moon about Jesus Christ, who was born as the only begotten Son. Pastor Ruth.
Thank you so much, Dr. Hendricks. And now we're going to turn to our readings. And our first Bible reading comes from the book of John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life. And our second reading comes from the book of John, chapter 14, verses 6. And I read, I am the way, the truth, and life. No one comes to the Father except through me. And now we're going to turn to our true parents, our true father's reflection on these two readings. And I read, in the Bible, Jesus is described as the only begotten Son. What does this mean? Jesus was the only person who inherited the total love and total lineage of God, and the only person who could represent it. For that reason, he had the power of God's lineage flowing through him. That is why he is the Savior. We know that God is the Father of mankind. Furthermore, Jesus is the only begotten Son of that God. Therefore, it is only through Jesus that we can be connected to the lineage of God. Otherwise, God's lineage cannot flow through mankind. John 3:16 says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life. The most important part of that verse is that God loved the world. However, many Christians put the greatest emphasis upon the second part of the verse, forgetting the most important thing, that God so loved the world. God did not love the church or the individual so much that he sent his only begotten Son. It was because God loved the world, the universe so much. Thus, Jesus is the one who was meant to save the world. When we believe in Jesus, the world is very much in our minds. God is in Jesus, and Jesus in God. Thank you. Jesus was born without sin. Jesus came without having anything to do with satanic blood. It had been completely separated from him. God had prepared this line for a long, long time so that Jesus could come as a sinless child. Therefore, he was indeed able to claim and the only begotten Son, the only Son of God. In human history, this was the first time a sinless child was born on earth. I'm one with God, Jesus said. The person who has seen me has seen the Father, he said. In the 14th chapter of the book of John, Jesus says, I am in my Father, and you in me, and I in you. He who has my commandments and keeps them, he it is who loves me, and he who loves me will be loved by my Father, and I will love him and manifest myself to him. So Jesus came to restore the sinless position of love, the love that had been lost since the time of Adam. This fact has not been known until now. There is a reason, a most important reason, why no one could come to the Father except by going through Jesus. He is our only bridge, our only hope, our only channel for reaching God. Therefore, Jesus proclaimed, I am the way, the truth, and the life, and without going through me, no one reaches the Father. There have been in human history many saints, many religious geniuses, and many wise men, but no one else could play the role of Jesus, who alone brings us to the Father. This is because he came in a stainless, sinless position, which no one else has. He is the only channel to reach God. Therefore, the birth of Jesus as the Messiah was the day of hope for all humankind. And may God bless these words. And you're listening to Holy Marriage Blessing, the ministry of the Unification Families of Kingston. And as we continue with our internal preparation for Christmas, let us reflect on why Jesus' birth was special, his purpose of coming, and what God wanted to achieve through the birth of Jesus. From our reading this morning, it is said that Jesus was the only begotten Son. Because he came without sin, he was born of God's lineage. Although Jesus was born in flesh, just like you and me, God had worked through Jesus' genealogy a way to reverse the fall of Adam and Eve, and had Mary's womb cleansed so that Jesus could be born without sin. Hence Jesus says, I am the way, the truth, and the life, and no one goes to the Father except through me. His purpose of coming was to show us the way of how we can also be cleansed and be engrafted unto him, and then we can also be reborn again into God's lineage, and also to be able to give birth to God's children, children just like Jesus, who have not sinned, and be able to multiply God's kingdom here on earth. By following the commandment of Jesus, that is the way, the truth, and the life, then we are able to become like Jesus. Jesus' Father says, "He who sees me has seen the Father. I am in my Father, and you in me, and I in you. He who has my commandments and keeps them, he who loves me will also be loved by my Father, and I will manifest myself to him." So through Jesus, God wanted to manifest himself into the world, not only through Jesus, but in all of us, if we follow Jesus' example. That was God's original plan of the creation. It is still the same until today. So, as we celebrate Christmas, let us have God and Jesus manifest themselves in us, and we will be able to multiply God's will and God's kingdom here on earth, and especially during this Christmas season. Thank you, and God bless you all, and have a very Merry Christmas.
Thank you so much, Pastor Ruth. Now, I want to share a little bit more about this notion and theological understanding of the only begotten Son. Jesus is the only begotten Son, but what does that really mean? The Bible says, or rather the Nicene Creed says, it's one substance with God. He was with God from the very beginning. Therefore, he was uncreated. He's not part of the rest of the creation. He's unique and therefore only begotten Son. Now, if we think about it, actually every child is begotten of God. Who else would create a child? Satan does not create children. Human beings on our own cannot create children. Of course, we're part of the process to create children. But ultimately, God is the one who begets us. Every religion teaches that there is a divine spark of God within each child, within each human being. That's because each human being is begotten of God. This is why God sends the sun to shine on the good and the evil. Everyone is the recipient of God's love and is begotten of God. But there's two ways of being begotten of God. There is purely begotten of God, and there is misbegotten of God. Now, purely begotten means that there's only one love, that God's love and husband's love and the wife's love are all mingled together. They are one love. That love is pure. That child is purely begotten. The fall of man was the serpent getting involved in the love relationship of Adam and Eve. That's why they covered their lower parts. They misused their lower parts. So the serpent, Satan, got involved in their love relationship. And once Satan is involved in the love relationship, Satan has a wedge to be involved in the procreation, in the results of their love relationship, that is their children. So Satan has an a priori claim on the children that rivals God's claim. God is the true parent, but Satan shoves his way in there as a false parent. And so we have two parents going in two different directions. God taking us toward good, Satan taking us toward evil. And such a child as is born in this fallen world is misbegotten. All children are begotten, but we need to be in a world where all children are purely begotten of God. Now, God made conditions through the people of Israel to bring forth the only begotten Son, Jesus, who was born without sin, purely begotten. And so Jesus was purely begotten. But here's the interesting thing to think about. Adam and Eve also were purely begotten, and yet they fell, and so they're not called only begotten. So it isn't just your birth, it's the way you live. It's your complete obedience to the Word of God and to the will of God. So Jesus is called only begotten because he was completely obedient at the cost of his life to the will of God. And there's one other person in the Bible who is called only begotten in the King James Bible. That person is Isaac, because Isaac gave his life on the altar, willing to be a sacrifice by his father, Abraham. He was saved. The angel stayed Abraham's hand and said, "Now I know you love the Lord. Also, now I know Isaac loves the Lord. Isaac loves his father." And so Isaac merits the title of only begotten, the only begotten son of Abraham. But Jesus is the only begotten son of God. Now that's the meaning of only begotten. Now how can we multiply the number of only begotten children in this world? It is through the holy marriage blessing. Because through the holy marriage blessing, we inherit the foundation that Mary had, the foundation of true parents, to bring forth only begotten children, purely begotten children, to bring forth purely begotten children without sin. It's not because we're great, it's because we inherit the foundation through Jesus and the Holy Spirit, who have come to the earth and ministered to us through our true parents, true father, Sun Myung Moon, true mother, Hak Ja Han Moon, who received the holy blessing, the holy marriage blessing in 1960, and have multiplied it to hundreds of thousands of millions of couples ever since. And we can bring forth, through the marriage blessing, children who are purely begotten and who can be called, if they fulfill their responsibility, only begotten son, only begotten daughter. This is the real gift of Christmas. This is the real internal preparation for Christmas. Share the marriage blessing. Share your love with your children. Share your love with your spouse. Make it pure. Make it centered on God. That's the best Christmas present of all. Thank you so much for listening. Holy Marriage Blessing Radio Ministry of the Unification Families of Kingston with our co-host, Pastor Ruth. Our music by Ronan Hardiman. I'm your host, Tyler Hendricks, wishing you a great week and a wonderful Christmas.
A star shining in a universe far away. My heart knows that we shall be